us again to your comforting and loving presence in our lives. Help us to be open to the many ways in which you make us ready to be of service to you. Amen. And our first hymn is number 238, Lead Us, Heavenly Father, Lead Us, O'er the World's Tempestuous Sea. Guard us, guide us, keep us, feed us, for we have no help but thee. Number 238. Forgive us, Lord, when we rely on our own strength and not yours, failing to make use of the spiritual armour you provide and are wounded in the fight. Forgive us, Lord, when we forget your provision and your love, listening instead to the insistent voices of this world and struggle to know what's right. Draw us close, Lord. Equip us with all that we need, empower us, strengthen our faith, so we can engage with this present world under the banner of your light. In your word, O Lord, we can put our trust. To you we can turn when struggling to cope, when faith is confused and its wisdom we seek. In your word, O Lord, we can put our trust. To you we can turn when the world goes through. Sin drags us down, and we're back at your feet. In your word we find wholeness and peace, enough for each day. In your word we find hope for tomorrow, such mercy and grace. In your word, O Lord, we can put our trust completely. Amen. And now Liz will give us our first reading.
Our first reading is from Joshua, chapter 24, verses 1 to 2 and 14 to 18. The covenant renewed at Shechem. Then Joshua assembled all the tribes of Israel at Shechem. He summoned the elders, leaders, judges, officials of Israel, and they presented themselves before God. Joshua said to all the people, "This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Long ago, your forefathers, including Terah, the father of Abraham and Nahor, lived beyond the river and worshipped other gods. Now fear the Lord and serve him with all faithfulness. Throw away the gods your forefathers worshipped beyond the river and in Egypt, and serve the Lord. But if serving the Lord seems undesirable to you, then choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your forefathers served beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in the land that you are living. But for me and for my household, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Well, far be it from us to forsake the Lord to serve other gods. It was the Lord our God himself who brought us and our fathers up out of Egypt from that land of slavery and performed those great signs before our eyes. He protected us on our entire journey and among all the nations through which we traveled. And the Lord drove out before us all the nations, including the Amorites, who lived in the land. We too will serve the Lord, because he is our God."
Choices. We make many choices throughout our lives. I often find it hard to make choices, deliberating far too long over some of them. I always blame being born under the star sign Libra, the scales, for my lack of decision. Well, that's my excuse anyway. Fortunately, most choices we make in life are fairly unimportant. It will probably make little difference whether we choose vanilla or raspberry or ripple ice cream, what colour we decorate our houses, chrysanthemums or asters to plant in the garden, whether we'd rather watch football or rugby, who's a dog person, who's a cat person. All these are a matter of choice, and happily we are all different. It's wonderful and important that we are all different. But the big important decision, which drives everything else we decide, is the direction we choose to face as we walk through life. In our reading from Joshua, the significance of this commitment is made thoroughly clear to the people, since Joshua wants to be sure that everyone really knows what they are voting for, together with the potential cost as well as benefits. Having laid out the facts, Joshua then gives the lead. He's not opting out of leadership and suggesting that either choice is as good as the other, but offers one direction as choosing life, the other death, and takes his stand on the good choice as he declares, "As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." The people wholeheartedly agree, basing their commitment on their actual experience of God's consistent loving care of them. In a genuine but over-enthusiastic desire to allow for freedom and engender mutual respect, our own age tends to now distrust any absolute, preferring to think of all truth as relative and a matter of individual choice. In such a climate, it takes courage to profess our faith in Jesus Christ. And we may find often we are in the minority or actively disputing widely accepted moral principles which run in contrary to God's law of love. We can also read in John 6, verses 56 to 69, some of the crowds that Jesus spoke to walk with him, because he seemed to them that he was making out that he was the Holy One of God. Jesus asked his disciples if they were going to turn away as well, and Peter spoke for them all, and for us as well. "Lord, who else could we go to?" he asked, "seeing that you are the one with the words of eternal life. When we know that God is real, and that Jesus really is the Holy One of God, what else can we do but make the sensible, wise choice and commit ourselves to following him? That's the wisest, most important choice we make in the whole of our life." Amen.
Number 663. I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in darkened sin, my hand will save. 663. Take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armour of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm, then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. Pray also for me, that whenever I open my mouth, words may be given me, that I will fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearlessly, as I should. May God bless the reading of this word.
In our readings today, we find out what it means to become a Christian. And as we know, Christian life is not going to be easy. In Joshua, the people of Israel are asked to make a choice between God and other gods. Their reply was that God had led them out of Egypt. He had kept his promise to them and continued to serve God. In the lectionary, it also gives us John 6, which Julie touched on, where it tells us, Jesus tells the crowd and his followers that he is the bread of life, that all should drink and feed from him. Just as we are in our communion, we drink wine, Ribena, and the bread that signifies this. The Israelites had a law in their church that states in Leviticus that they should not eat and drink the blood of an animal. The crowd misunderstood, along with some of the followers of Jesus, and left. Then Jesus asked the difficult question in the Bible, the most difficult question in the Bible. He asked the disciples, "Do you want to leave me too?" And Peter answered, "To whom shall we go, as your words are the eternal life?" This tells us that we will have difficult decisions in life. So what does Jesus tell us to do? In Ephesians, it tells us to put our armour on. So what is the armour of God? Let's look and watch individually. Here are some pictures. Firstly, we put on the belt of truth. The truth keeps us from giving in to world's beliefs and actions to the truth of the Word of God. Secondly, the breastplate of righteousness. Righteousness is being honest, good, humble and fair to others. It means standing up for the weak. Thirdly, put on the feet prepared with the gospel of peace. The gospel of peace is being right with God and being content in troubled times. Jesus said, "The peacemakers will be blessed." Number four, the shield of faith. Faith is being sure that God will keep his promises. Faith in God protects you when you are tempted with doubt. And fifth, the helmet of salvation. Put on your helmet of salvation by believing that Jesus died for your sins and rose again. Lastly, number six, the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. God's word is our offensive weapon. When we tell others that the old Bible says the Spirit, Holy Spirit helps people see their bad thoughts and actions and make them want to be forgiven. Here, the armour of God, to be honest, is a lot to carry, and it would have been very heavy if we had a real picture of it. I don't know about you, but I wonder how the knights of old got round with all that armour on. No one told us that being a Christian, that our lives would be easy, but every day we wake up and we put our armour on. Our armour that God has given us, to take each day as it comes. He and He alone is the answer to our prayers. He keeps every promise He makes to us and walks beside us all the way. God gave us the Holy Spirit because we know that His gospel is true. We have faith in Him. We have His peace in our hearts, and this army's victory is that Jesus died for our sin and rose again. Amen. Right, we're going to sing our next hymn, number 395, Spirit of the Living God, fall afresh on me. Jesus, Holy One, surround us with your spiritual armour, all who defend the vulnerable and powerless. Give courage to leaders to advance the cause of your equity. Sustain the integrity of those under pressure, where conflict and selfishness will triumph. Sing praise to the Lord. Jesus, Holy One, you know the championships of friends and the pain of people turning away. Be with the lonely and those who have been abandoned. May we be secure in your love and affirmation. Sing praises to the Lord. Jesus, Holy One, speak words of peace to all whose mind is troubled. Bless all whatever our distress. Open your ears to our cry. Sing praise to the Lord. Jesus, Holy One, be near to the broken-hearted. Raise up those who have died. Grant that we may dwell in your house forever. Amen. And we say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now, I'm going to sing an old hymn that unfortunately they didn't put in singing the faith. Stand up for Jesus, ye soldiers of the church. Lift high his royal banner, it must not suffer loss.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love.